What turned Venus into hell? And why did Earth survive? Have you heard of the expression, same person, different font? That's the case we are dealing with in this video. Why is Venus the hottest planet? It's not the closest one to the Sun, though. You may have heard that Venus is often referred to as Earth's sister planet. But did you know that it's a literal hellish landscape, with temperatures hot enough to melt lead and crushing atmospheric pressure that can't squish you flat? It's safer to say Venus is Earth's evil twin, then. So what turned Venus into this inferno while Earth remains a habitable oasis? Join me as we delve into the science behind the two planets and uncover the factors that led to their vastly different fates. From the role of greenhouse gases and the effects of volcanic activity, to the impact of the Sun's radiation and the absence of a magnetic field, we'll explore the many factors that make Venus a hostile environment and Earth a welcoming home. But that's not all. We'll also examine the potential consequences of climate change and the lessons we can learn from Venus to ensure the future of our own planet. What turned Venus into hell? Venus is often called Earth's sister planet because it is similar in size, mass, and composition. However, the similarities end there. While Earth is a habitable planet, Venus is a lifeless, hellish environment with temperatures hot enough to melt lead and an atmosphere that is toxic and dense. There are several factors that have turned Venus into a hostile environment, including its distance from the Sun, its atmosphere, and its unique geological history. One of the primary reasons why Venus is so hot and inhospitable is its proximity to the Sun. Venus is the second planet from the Sun, and it is located closer to the Sun than Earth. As a result, Venus receives much more solar radiation than Earth does. This intense radiation causes the planet's temperature to rise, resulting in a runaway greenhouse effect. Before we get into the greenhouse effect, let's address a cool point. Venus's slow and retrograde rotation is a unique feature that may have played a role in its extreme atmospheric conditions. Venus rotates once every 243 Earth days, which is longer than its year, meaning that a day on Venus is longer than a year. In addition, Venus's rotation is retrograde, meaning that it rotates in the opposite direction of most other planets in our solar system, including Earth. One theory for the origin of Venus's slow and retrograde rotation is that it was caused by a massive impact during the planet's early history. This impact could have been large enough to completely stop Venus's rotation and then reverse it, causing the planet to spin in the opposite direction. However, this theory is still a subject of scientific debate, and further research is needed to confirm it. In contrast, Earth's rotational speed is much faster, and it rotates in the same direction as it orbits the Sun. This is due to the impact of a large object, likely a Mars-sized object early in its history. This impact is thought to have caused the ejection of a large amount of material into orbit around the Earth, which eventually coalesced to form the Moon. The gravitational interactions between the Earth and the Moon have helped to stabilize the Earth's rotational axis, preventing large changes in its axial tilt and helping to maintain a stable climate over long periods of time. The greenhouse effect occurs when gases in a planet's atmosphere trap heat from the Sun, causing the planet's temperature to increase. On Venus, the thick atmosphere, which is composed mostly of carbon dioxide, traps heat and prevents it from escaping back into space. This results in a feedback loop, where the planet's temperature continues to rise, making the greenhouse effect even more intense. Another factor that has turned Venus into a hostile environment is its atmosphere. Venus's atmosphere is around 100 times denser than Earth's atmosphere, and it is composed primarily of carbon dioxide. This means that the atmospheric pressure on the surface of Venus is incredibly high, making it difficult for any spacecraft to land on the planet's surface. The thick atmosphere on Venus also prevents heat from escaping back into space, contributing to the planet's high surface temperature. The thick clouds on Venus also block most of the sunlight from reaching the planet's surface, creating a dim environment with little to no sunlight. Venus's geological history has also played a role in its transformation into a hellish environment. Venus has a very slow rotation, which means that a single day on Venus is longer than a year on the planet. This slow rotation combined with the intense heat has caused the planet's surface to undergo massive volcanic activity. Volcanic activity on Venus releases large amounts of gas into the atmosphere, including sulfur dioxide, which contributes to the greenhouse effect. The planet's volcanic activity also has led to the formation of vast plains of solidified lava, which cover around 80% of the planet's surface. Why did Earth survive? Earth's ability to support life is due to several factors that have allowed it to maintain a stable environment over billions of years. These factors include its distance from the Sun, its atmosphere, its gradual geological history, and the stabilizing effects of its large moon. One of the primary factors that have contributed to Earth's ability to support life is its distance from the Sun. Earth is located in the Goldilocks zone of our solar system, which is the range of distances from the Sun that are just right for the planet to support liquid water, a key ingredient for life as we know it. If Earth were located closer to the Sun like Venus, it would be too hot for liquid water to exist on its surface, while even if it were located further away like Mars, it would be too cold. Earth's atmosphere has also played a key role in its ability to support life. The Earth's atmosphere is composed of a mix of gases, including nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide, and other trace gases. This mix of gases has allowed for the regulation of the planet's temperature, as well as providing the necessary ingredients for life. The atmosphere on Earth also contains a protective layer of ozone, which helps to block harmful ultraviolet radiation from the Sun. This protection is crucial for life to survive on the planet's surface, as high levels of UV radiation can cause DNA damage and other harmful effects. Another important factor that has contributed to Earth's ability to support life and its gradual geological history. Unlike Venus, which has undergone massive volcanic activity, Earth's geological history has been relatively stable and gradual over time. This has allowed for the planet's atmosphere to evolve gradually rather than experiencing catastrophic changes. Additionally, plate tectonics is another factor that has contributed to Earth's ability to support life and is absent on Venus. Plate tectonics is the movement of the Earth's lithosphere, which is the rigid outermost shell that includes the crust and uppermost part of the mantle, into separate pieces called plates. These plates move slowly across the surface of the Earth, colliding and pulling apart in certain areas. The movement of these plates plays a crucial role in the formation of mountain ranges, the recycling of nutrients, and the release of gases from the Earth's mantle. In addition, the movement of the plates helps to release heat from the Earth's mantle, which can help to prevent the buildup of pressure that leads to large volcanic eruptions. In contrast, Venus does not have plate tectonics. Its crust is much thicker than Earth's, which prevents the movement of the lithosphere. As a result, the heat and pressure from the mantle are not released as efficiently, which can lead to catastrophic volcanic eruptions. Another important factor that has contributed to Earth's ability to support life is its large moon. The moon's gravitational pull helps to stabilize Earth's rotation, which in turn helps to stabilize the planet's climate. Additionally, the moon's gravitational pull creates tides, which have played a role in the evolution of life on Earth by creating a diverse range of habitats for marine organisms. Consequences of climate change and lessons to learn from Venus. Climate change is expected to have a wide range of consequences, both on a global and local scale. Some of the most significant consequences include rising sea levels. As temperatures rise, glaciers and polar ice caps melt, leading to a rise in sea levels. This can lead to coastal flooding, erosion, and the loss of land. More frequent and intense natural disasters. Climate change can increase the likelihood and intensity of natural disasters, such as hurricanes, tornadoes, wildfires, and floods. Changes in precipitation patterns. Climate change can disrupt rainfall patterns, leading to more droughts in some areas and more floods in others. This can impact agriculture and water availability. Loss of biodiversity. Climate change can lead to the extinction of species as ecosystems are disrupted and temperatures become unsuitable for certain plants and animals. Health impacts. Climate change can impact human health through increased exposure to air pollution, the spread of disease-carrying insects, and heat-related illnesses. The lessons we can learn from Venus are that the greenhouse effect can have severe consequences for a planet's climate, and that we need to take action to prevent similar outcomes on Earth. By reducing our greenhouse gas emissions and transitioning to cleaner forms of energy, we can prevent the worst effects of climate change and ensure a more sustainable future for our planet. Venus and Earth are two planets that are similar in size and composition, but their environments have been vastly different. Venus has become a hellish environment due to several factors, including its proximity to the Sun, its thick carbon dioxide atmosphere, and its unique geological history. In contrast, Earth has maintained a stable environment that is well suited for supporting life, thanks to its distance from the Sun, its mix of gases in the atmosphere, its gradual geological history, and the stabilizing effects of its large moon. The study of Venus and Earth offers insights into the factors that contribute to the habitability of planets. As we continue to explore our solar system and beyond, it will be important to understand how these factors work together to create and sustain life, and how they may vary on other planets. Ultimately, this knowledge may help us to identify habitable environments elsewhere in the universe and to better understand the potential for life beyond our own planet. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video, where we'll explore more fascinating discoveries about our universe. Don't forget to like, subscribe to our channel to stay tuned with our latest videos and most exciting subjects. Let us know in the comments what you think about these reasons and if you can think of other ones. We care about what you think.